but they have renounced hidden things of dishonesty, not working in craftiness or handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to men's conscience in the sight of the Lord. But if our gospel is hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world is blinded the minds of them that believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine upon them. I ask Father Hilary to open the door of prayer. This week I'll be leaving for the convention in America.
Pastor Westcore was preaching last year.
Now we come to where we learn the Bible. So we won't drag very long, we'll just take a short time. Channels that God uses to communicate with us. And I mentioned that we like to help those with the different gifts that God is using them to
watch.
Perfect picture.
Without
plans, what to read.
In that ministry, God calls out a bride. Without spot or wrinkle. A skin of was the seventh from Adam.
Pay my rent as I'll pay my rent.
No one will help me pay my rent as I'll pay my rent.
No one will
kumele othule.
Kunezinga lapho umuntu kumele phile
khona. And the ministry ought to take you to those levels.
Inkonzo kumele ukuhambise kwelo zinga.
Manifestation of Christ's resurrection.
He's alive. He keeps
every
promise.
This ministry is the manifestation
of Christ's resurrection.
This ministry does not tools and dogs. Go to make a way for you to see.
Oh,
see, Brother God, come here this afternoon. desire. I don't care what it is.
You
want to know that God gave this ministry. Anything that you desire. I say the Lord. If you speak it, I will speak it behind you. And you heard it right there. And there were eight people standing there and sister head. So a proof of the ministry.
Don't follow the crowd.
over my mother on earth, but came from above. He came from God, and he goes back to God. Father, this thing is spiritual. We are spiritual astronauts. This old world can never hold us. Any moment, we shall be gone. The fashions of this world can never hold us. As the astronaut, brother,
he'll
be looking at the spiritual raptors. He's not alone, though he's alone somewhere there.
They
are in spiritual raptors controlling his moves.
Brother,
there's something that controls my moves. I don't appear in the raptors of witches. When they try to Google me in their networks, when they try to throw their bones, they can't pick nothing about me. But when you open this, you are going to pick something about me. You are tracing my bloodline in the word of God. Because my theophany is built around the word of God. As we enter the word of God, something in us is permanently changed. When you come into you come as a discouraged person. But you say, I will enter his courts with thanksgiving in my heart. I will say, this is the day.
You start rejoicing.
Even if before you see what you are asking for, before you receive what you are asking for, as long as you receive, the one who will give you, you start rejoicing. Responding to the sermon before laying on of hands, I was preaching with Inari Nkweru, and there was a woman with a blinded eye that was swollen. And the
mouth
opened during the preaching. I've seen deaf ears opening because the word was forcing its way into the ears. I've seen marriages that were broken. Broken has been mended. See with this ministry. We don't change, brothers. See with this ministry. When your boss threatens you, bring your threatenings to the altar. When your health is, your body is suffering pain, bring it to the ministry. Something will happen. I'm not banking on the Ministry of Finance or the Ministry of Home Affairs, but on this ministry, Father, the word of God will never pass away. I've seen God dissolving cancers. I read about it, and I saw it as I was preaching. I read about the Holy Ghost, but I experienced it. After experiencing it, when I was preaching it, I saw people receiving it. And this very day, I know that he is here now to answer his children. We are still in the red letters of the Bible. What is Christ himself speaking? We only live by that
same
Lord.
That
same Lord will never fail.
Father,
in the spoken word, we are carrying thousands of that same Lord that are happening every day. And Father, no matter how hard your situation is, those Christians that you are writing off, bring them to the ministry. Those people that you say nothing shall come out of this person,
this
death all over in your life, rejection and hopelessness all over in your life, when Jesus comes,
kitu.
The power of God came down by receiving glory, hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
Came down. That's why we are happy. This is the reason I see and I shout. Because Jesus came down and lifted me up. No matter what Mary came you are in.
Also the
Unlike the healing and deliverance ministry.
Churches
a higher quality of Christians. That will never open to the world. I pray that God will crown your ministry also.
whatever it is. What are your ministry? Is the ministry of being a housewife? I pray that God will crown your ministry. It may be the ministry of being a preacher. It may be the ministry of being a deacon. It may be the ministry of being a lay member. It may be as a farmer. I don't know what it is. What may God crown your life? When he was taken up, Elisha had a double portion. So he must see a double portion of the ministry. Now, how many ministers here believe that this ministry is the Lord Jesus Christ? Yes. This ministry is the ministry of Jesus Christ. This ministry that he gave them was actually the sharing of this one ministry. Because he was working in them. The characteristics of Elijah ministry was in about 5 minutes. He's a prophet of fire, he was always pulling out fire. That's why you see the pillar of fire coming down. It was fearless. And that John the Baptist, he would even approach the king there.
We are
experiencing greater things of God.
But we also believe
siyakholelwa
under this ministry
ulinkonzo
that when you die we are in Christ
ukuthi ungafela kuKristu
step beyond the kingdom of time
uyadlulela kukhetheni
esikhathi that voice was saying person brother
yipho wezi people lesi kubeka mzalwane
know what is in store for you
nokwazi ngokuphambili
there is a realm where you live when this body is dissolved
kunezingo phila kilo mali elidokodo lamzimba
leli what's happening
umuntu is thunywa
speaks to his people through human beings God is choosing someone that he can use. And he can make you grow and speak to you through books and texts.
We are going to find a way that cool
when a man that's really born again of the Spirit of God,
Oya kakulu kuli kumisele.
Has planted the personal God is in him.
Ukulu kulu kukui.
What we try in this ministry?
Esimzama yuli kosa.
That you should not beg for the testimonies of your pastor.
Awumela utembe ufaka sekamfuti.
You must have your personal God.
Umelke ukulu kulu wako.
What happened in Nicolaitan 16?
Okwenze kala ukosi ukulu.
They took away God from the people and put them in a man.
Basusu ukulu kule batu inu.
But the true ministry puts.
Ikoze kini so.
Puts God in the people.
Ega ukulu kule batu.
He knows that he's going from a ridicule to supply. You are going from a where they are despising you to a higher place. Now, as we are closing, now as we are about to pray, how many in this building will want to be healed right now? By God. I'm telling you, God in these preachers here. And God is in you also. God is here now. God loves you. Do you believe that? It's enough for cancer to leave you.
But
such as we have, we give unto you. God says you do greater works. We are the manifested sons of God. The God I preach is not a God of history. That is worrying you now. We can challenge it now. Before you go out of that door, we can challenge that situation now. I will stand here rebuking your situation, and your situation will respond. I will stand here rebuking apostasy and backsliding. I will stand here rebuking evil family spirits. He can speak for himself.
Yes,
and if you are in this room and you need the Holy Spirit, I say you can receive that Holy Spirit now. And close your eyes. I've seen God raising people from wheelchair. But I'm expecting something now. I'm expecting that God that you have heard about to come down. Maybe you are here because of the maybe you are here because there is something troubling your heart. Maybe you are here because you are trying your heart. Our God is able, my sister. Our God has empowered the ministry to deal with your circumstances. Now everyone will pray here. And no one will be faint. Everyone will pray defying the devil. You are part of the ministry. We are not going to allow everything. We are not going to allow arthritis. We are in the presence of God. Those with cataracts, I say they disappear now. Whether it's fibroids, I've seen God healing spinal problems. When people receive the word, upon them. At this moment, I put every spirit under my feet right now. Most upon devils, I paralyze them. Most satanism spirits, I paralyze them. As I stand as an ambassador of the throne of God, I'm told by the Bible that what we bind on earth is bound in heaven. It's into every single person. Whatever pain you're passing through, I don't allow you to go out with that same pain. He is bowing to you. The great physician is here. The great emancipator is here. You must see results. Not tomorrow. Results now. As you shall all pray now, you shall leave this place without pains. Those who need the Holy Spirit must receive the Holy Ghost today. He is a God of the now. Is it my
my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and seek my face. If you are repenting, young boy, if you are sick and tired of those dirty habits, our God is here to set you free. He will give you power to overcome. He will give you power to live a clean life. He will give you victory over sin and purity divine. Our Heavenly Father, this ministry that you have given us, you promised that nothing shall by any means stand before us. You promised, oh Father, that when we speak, you shall perform it. You promised, Father, that you will never leave us, but to be with us, even to the end of the world. You promised that when two or three are gathered in your name, you shall be there. You said you are the Lord that healed all our diseases. You said by your stripes we are healed. You said, Father, in those last days you shall pour your spirit. You said, Father, a brother will say, I give you rain, and it shall come. You said, Father, missing limbs will be restored, and they shall be restored. You said there is a church coming in power that shall speak the word, and it will flash like lightning. You, Father, you will confirm your presence with signs and wonders. You said, greater is he that is within us than the one in the world. You said, if the enemy comes like a flood, you will raise a standard. You said, your promises can never fail. You said, what whatsoever we desire, when we shall pray believing, we shall have them. We said, if we speak the word of our Father, blessed is she that believeth, there shall be a performance. You said, Father, watch the dead pool there. You said, Father, when you're in the preaching of the word, it casts out devils. You said, Father, things will happen that you have never seen before. I take it, Lord, Father, as a challenge, as dead as your servant, and I say, let it be. Let the Holy Spirit come down now in a rushing mighty wind and fill your children with the power. Fill the backsliders with the power. I paralyze all demon powers. Satan, release the people of God now. You have no power, you demons. You HIV, you have no power. You mountains, move right now in the name of Jesus. I'm speaking under the anointing, breaking every chain, breaking every yoke, breaking every power of the enemy. Satan, you are defeated. You evil spirits, you family spirits, release them now. I adjure you, as I call the fire of God now, as I stand on my post of duty, and I say, such as I have, I give to the church of God. Let there be showers of blessing. Let there be breakthroughs. Whatever your children, repent and come back to God. May they make right. May they confess. May they defy all the armies of hell. May they defy all the lustful devils. May they defy all the evil habits. In the name of Jesus, let there be a performance. Right now, the fire is coming down. Right now, the power of God is coming down to baptize your people, Lord. May they receive the Holy Spirit. May they receive the power now. In the name of Jesus, it shall come to pass. In the last days, I'll pour my spirit upon all flesh. This is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. Father, may you visit your people. Some are thirsting, some are hungering, some are crying at the altar, saying, Father, do not pass me by. They have burdens, they have practical situations, and they are saying, where is the God of Elijah? Where is the God of the Bible? Where is the God that answers by fire? Where is the God that heals? Where is that God that specializes in things not impossible? This 7th of July, may it mark a spiritual turnaround for this church. As they stand in the judgment of time, the God that has called me in this ministry, the God that promised to back this ministry with signs and wonders, will never fail us. Heavenly Father, your children are in situations, they're in circumstances, they are sick and tired, they are saying enough is enough. Oh Heavenly Father, want to visit them this afternoon, O Lord, may you revive them. Oh, they are sisters, we're almost giving up. They are brothers, we're almost giving up. But under this atmosphere, may something rejuvenate them. May something energize them. May they raise with power and say, it's over, it's done, it's finished. In the name of Jesus, that name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every demon enforcing it to bow, you Satan. forcing you now. You shall bow. You shall agree that this message has power. The end time message will meet end time conditions. Whatever condition, whether it's rivers that no can cross it, whether it's mountains that they cannot tunnel through, whether it's life situations, Father, I know that Father, when you spoke to me at home, before I came here, you told me that your children, if they step into that sphere, they shall receive. It's now in their lap. Father, I don't need to lay hands on any of them. But that power now will visit them. That power will meet them as they are praying. All burdens will go away from there. May there be miracle after miracle. May there be visitation after visitation. May the anointing burst the airlock. May the anointing touch those with backaches. May the anointing remove arthritis, diabetes, and all those things. Satan, wherever you are, you cannot hide from me now. I'm going to search and expose every devil that is hiding in this building. I'm going to search and expose by the Spirit of God all forces that are keeping the children of God in bondage. So surrender, you Satan. Surrender now in the name of Jesus. Oh Heavenly Father, have mercy. You said if we cast our cares on you, you care for us. Some brother are bleeding with tears of repentance. Their hearts are touched. They are feeling a burden in their hearts. They are saying, what shall we do? Father, may they repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin. And they shall receive what we have received. They shall receive the power. Oh Lord Jesus, my heart is pained and is groaning when I see our youth failing to grasp it, failing to connect with the supernatural power. When I see them living in sin, Father, I say, Lord, remember them as I stand in the gap in prayer. Father, have mercy on our families, on the Christians of today, on the believers of today. May you open their eyes up and bring them back to Bible days again, back to the family altar, back to repentance, back to the original gospel, back to making right, back to living true, back to the God, Holy Ghost gospel. Heavenly Father, may you move among your children. Father, it cannot help us if we gather here and we hear God of history. If that God cannot rise from history and do the same works. But Father, I'm feeling right now a confirmation that something has happened in the hearts of your children. Father, he that started the good work will finish it. You will never abort the work, O Lord Father. You will lead your children even in shady green pastures, even to the paths of righteousness. Though they pass through the waters and the fires and the floods, though they pass through great trials, though they pass through great sorrows, may they be the rainbow trout that will never be discouraged. May they hold on, because he that endureth up to the end, the same shall be saved. Father, I know there are some who have no food at all. Your hand can provide. There are some who have no rentals and monies for fees and for school and for exams. May your hand miraculously provide. Father, take this church to another phase where they see Jesus in their daily life, where they see your power operating in their lives daily. Father, I worship you. I glorify your name. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. Bless your children. As I call this song leader, I will invite only those who are still new. As we are singing now, they can come forward. I won't have enough time to go to the back room. Those who are still new, I won't see anyone in the back room, so I'll just pray for you now. Just believe.
Sayo.